Content sharing app Instagram rolls out several new safety features for teenagers. And as this report tells us, the rollout comes a day before the head of the social network appears in Congress.
Instagram announced a slew of changes meant to better protect teenage users of the image sharing app. The new rules come just before Adam Mosseri, the head of Instagram, is set to testify before Congress. Through a blog post, Instagram on Tuesday said it will more carefully curate the kinds of content it recommends to teenagers and will try to nudge youngsters if they dwell on one topic for too long. The photo sharing app and its parent company Meta, formerly known as Facebook, both have been under fire for the ways their services could present an online safety risk for younger users and cause body image issues for teenage girls. Scrutiny from lawmakers and state attorneys general ratcheted up after a Wall Street Journal report said internal documents leaked by former Facebook employee Francis Hogan showed the company knew Instagram could have harmful mental effects on teenage girls. Facebook has said the leaked documents have been used to paint a false picture of the company's work. Instagram's announcement isn't likely to change what is sure to be a bipartisan tongue-lashing at Wednesday's Senate hearing. In response to the blog post, Republican Senator Marsha Blackburn criticized the announcement, calling it, quote, hollow, and in a statement said, quote, Meta is attempting to shift attention from their mistakes by rolling out parental guides, use timers, and content control features that consumers should have had all along. Instagram said it will roll out its first tools for parents and guardians to see how much time their teens spend on the app and set time limits early next year. An Instagram spokeswoman said it would continue its pause on plans for a version of Instagram for kids. That project was suspended amid growing opposition.
The U.S. House of Representatives approves a measure to speed up the passage of legislation that would raise the federal government's debt limit. The Senate is expected to take up the measure on Thursday. The bill would speed the way for Congress to consider separate legislation to increase the current $28.9 trillion limit on federal borrowing authority. This would stave off a potential historic default, which is projected to happen in mid-December. A new report shows the share of global wealth of the world's richest people soared to a record pace during the pandemic. The World Inequality Report said 2020 marked the steepest increase in the wealth of billionaires, rising $4 trillion. This means 1% of global population now owns over 3% of its wealth. On the flip side, 100 million people joined the ranks of extreme poverty when the pandemic struck. A ranking by Forbes magazine shows the top 10 richest people each have a net worth exceeding $100 billion, with Tesla boss Elon Musk on top with over $246 billion. The report now calls for a modest progressive wealth tax on the rich in order to redistribute wealth, along with new measures to prevent tax evasion. Nissan expects global supply chain constraints and sector-wide semiconductor shortage to continue on until at least mid-2022. The parts and chip shortage caused problems globally, with Nissan cutting its original target of making 4.4 million cars this year to 3.8 million. Global car production for 2021 is expected to hit nearly 80 million, still below the pre-shortage average of 95 to 97 million units. Nissan's CEO admits it would take some time to return to normal operations.
The pandemic has really disrupted the supply chain around the world, and automotive industry have been impacted much more than expected. And why it has been impacted much more than expected? Because one reason was the production plants were closed, and obviously it created the supply-demand gap. But the most important thing is during the pandemic, the usage of the of some of the critical raw materials and the parts multiplied for the non-automotive. And because automotive do not control the non-automotive supply chain, and being the parts which are common between these two, created unpredictability in the forecast. I think it will take some more time to get back to the normal operations.